ASOT, the ASOT test, or the anti-streptolysin test. This is a blood test that is actually being requested for patients in many parts of the world by some doctors. If the result of the test is high, and in the absence of any other signs of a specific medical problem, many patients are prescribed injections of long-acting penicillin. This is not a correct medical decision by any means. If this happened to you before, or if this is what you are experiencing now, this video is for you. In this video, we will give you the most important pieces of info that you need to know about the blood test anti-streptolysin test. This is Dr. Hatem Eleishi. I'm a professor of rheumatology at Cairo University in Egypt and the director of Tabibakom Online, which is a platform for online consultations. What we present here is a series of videos about the different types of arthritis and how to manage them. Before we start, please make sure you have subscribed to my channel. You will find a lot of videos here on this channel that will help you with arthritis. The ASOT test, or the anti-streptolysin test, is over-requested in laboratories on a daily basis in many parts of the world. What we need to know about this test here is, if the result of the test is high, what does that mean? Second, when should this test be ordered by the doctor anyway? Third, why is this test requested more than it should be? What is the non-scientific scenario for ordering that test? Lastly, and who is requesting this blood test out of place? I mean, who is over-requesting this test all the time? So, we start with the first point. If the result of the test is high, what does that mean? If the result of the test is high, it reflects that you have antibodies against a microbe called the streptococcus microbe. This in itself is not a discovery. It is not always a problem even at all. Alone, without any other signs associated with the blood test result, there is no diagnosis that needs to be made here. Each one of us, over the year, his immune system will be fighting a streptococcus infection at one or more points in time, and the ASOT blood test, if high, it will only reflect that you are fighting or were just fighting this microbe, a routine task that your immune system does from time to time without you feeling any symptoms of any disease. If repeated in a couple of weeks, the test result will likely go down on its own. However, if the test result was associated with certain signs or symptoms like an intense swollen single joint, I repeat, single joint, that abates in a couple of days to be followed by another joint that will be inflamed too, or if it associates with an inflammation of the valves of the heart or a certain type of skin rash, only then we might consider, based on the clinical evaluation, if the patient has the disease that we call rheumatic fever. Otherwise, the ASOT test result has no value really. When should this test be ordered then by the doctor? Only if the clinical picture of the patient suggests the disease called rheumatic fever or an intense infection with the streptococcus microbe. These are also the situations where we might need to prescribe long-acting penicillin injections. Next point, why is this test requested more than it should be? What is the non-scientific scenario for ordering that test? In some clinics, this test is requested for evaluation of aches in the joints in general or arthritis of many joints in the body. It is important to note here that the different causes for aches in the body or arthritis of several joints together do not include any reason for which we need to request this anti-streptolysin test. And who is requesting this blood test out of place? I mean, who is over-requesting this test all the time? Non-specialists in some regions of the world who insist on evaluating patients with aches or patients with arthritis without enough background and enough knowledge in their diagnosis and management. Conclusion? Conclusion? If you were prescribed a long-acting penicillin injection by a non-specialist only because of a high result of an anti-streptolysin test, you need to consult a cardiologist first who will confirm if you have rheumatic fever affecting the heart or not. This is the most important thing to do. This is the priority to do. And also, if those injections were prescribed for any aches all over or for arthritis of multiple joints in your body, you better see a specialist, a rheumatologist, to get the right diagnosis for your symptoms, as your diagnosis will never be rheumatic fever or any indication for penicillin injections. Thank you so much.